If you're on any kind of social media and you're into things like mecha robots and stuff like that, chances are you've heard of a company called Gravastar. They specialize in making several different products with a very mecha-inspired theme, and they actually sent me their Alpha 65 charger to review today. I know it's not a model kit, but I mean, it's still mecha, so I kinda let this one slide. But anyways, without further ado, let's check it out. Always a joy to have that little bit of box suction. So inside the box we get what look like to be decals. Let's open this up real quick before I reveal what's underneath. Ooh, these are actually water slide decals. Not bad. Mine did come with a little bit of a crease, so that is a little unfortunate, but I mean, there's so many different decals to pick from. I'm probably not going to use every single one. And underneath we have the charger itself. It actually looks a lot smaller than I expected. I mean, look at it. This thing's really tiny. I expected it to look a lot more like a big kind of laptop charger. Got a user manual. And these two things here in the box look like they're little ears. And the cool thing about them is they magnetically attach. So there's really not much assembling going on here. It's just the charger itself, and then you add on the magnetic ears, which doesn't take much effort at all. Maybe you can see here on the top, we do have the Gravastar logo. And as you can see, there are three ports on here. There are two USB-C ports and one USB-A port. And on the sides, of course, we have some legs. There is a little bit of articulation with these. Not too much, but enough to where you can somewhat pose it a little bit. We get one bend here at the knee, and it kind of just like locks into place at the maximum range. And then we can bend it again at the, I guess what would be the hip. And that again locks into place like that. And same thing on the other side. So there it is. Cute little guy. It kind of reminds me of like a Haro put together with a Star Wars AT-ST. And lastly, on the bottom there is the fold-out plug. Chances are, unless you're using an extension cable, you'll probably have to fold the legs in. That way it can reach the outlet. So there's really not much to talk about aesthetics-wise regarding this charger. I mean, what you see is what you get. There are a few customization options you can do with the decals. And some people have even gone as far as painting the entire thing as if it were a model kit. And looking at the box, I realize now I have the ears on opposite sides. So this thing is rated to work between 110 and 240 volts. For us here in America, that means no problem at all. Anyone else, you might want to double check with Gravastar on the specs of it, just to make sure it's compliant in your region. And as I mentioned before, there are three slots on the top. Now, with this charger, you can get a total of 65 watt output, whether you're using one port, two port, or all three ports. However, you will need at least one USB-C cable in order to utilize the full power of this charger. I'll throw up the chart that they have on their website, but there are a couple different combinations you can use that end up with varying output levels. Obviously, you can see from top to bottom, if you're using just one port, the top port will give you 18 watts, the middle port is 20 watts, and the bottom port is 65 watts. If you're using both of the USB-C ports, you'll get the 20 watt port and the 65 watt port will convert down to 45 watts. Same thing if you're using the USB-A port as well as the 65 watt port, it'll go from 65 watts down to 45 watts. If you use the middle port and the top port, both of those will have, I believe, a 15 watt combined max. And if you use all three ports, the bottom port will give you 45, and the top two will have a combined output of 15 watts. Now, I wanted to check how much power is actually being delivered when I charge my phone with this charger, but I did find out that the iPhone 12 Pro Max can only really accept up to 20 watts of charge. So unfortunately, that's not something I can test right now, but if I do come up with some way to test it in the future, I'll make sure to post the results down in the comments below. And one thing I left out is when you plug it in, the eyes light up. They actually stay lit for kind of a long time. If you are a mecha enthusiast and you're looking for a charger for either your smartphone, your tablet, or even your laptop or game console, then consider checking out Gravastar's Alpha 65 charger. Not only does it come in white, but it also comes in a custom yellow or blue. And like I said, if you really wanted to, you could customize it yourself and use some of the water slide decals that come with it. But anyways, that's it for today's review. Hope you learned something. Even if it's just that there's a company out there that sells Mecha chargers. But anyways, as usual, have a good rest of your day. Pick up a kit and start building.